It's an unsettling statistic. A deadly shooting in Kentucky now means there have been more mass shootings in America than days so far this year. Five bank staff in Louisville were killed by a worker recently told he'd been fired, the man live streaming his rampage.
An all too familiar sound. And this is the man behind America's latest mass shooting. Connor Sturgeon had been told he was going to be fired from the Old National Bank in Louisville and wrote to his parents, warning he could kill. Authorities say just before 8:30 this morning, that became reality.
He's texted a friend, called a friend, left a voicemail, he's going to kill everyone at the bank, feeling suicidal.
Shots fired again.
Sturgeon was armed with an AR-15 style rifle, opening fire while live streaming on Instagram.
This was an evil act of targeted violence.
Some people hid in the bank's vault, others ran.
We heard a click and the lady next to me turned around and said, what the hell, and he just started shooting.
Police were on scene 3 minutes after they were called. There was an exchange of gunfire, then the shooter was dead. Killed five bank staff.
I have a very close friend that didn't make it today. And I have another close friend who didn't either.
Late today, police moved in on Sturgeon's home. The gunman was once a star athlete who had suffered multiple concussions. This morning, a series of disturbing posts to his Instagram page, ending with, I know what I have to do, but I don't know if I have the strength to do it. Among the injured, Officer Nicholas Wilt, shot in the head, trying to protect others. He graduated from the police academy just 10 days ago.
I just swore him in, and his family was there to witness his journey to become a police officer.
This was the 146th mass shooting in the US in the first 100 days of this year, and once again, the White House is pleading for help on gun control.
Too many Americans are paying with their lives.
In the United States, Jonathan Kersley, Nine News.